Well, hello, Mr. Bai. It is nighttime here in New York City. Morning where you are. And once again, we have the superstar Chu Chen with us translating. Thank you, Chu. Mr. Bai, you are so multi-talented. You sing, you act, you do comedy, you do sketches. I want to know when you knew you were funny. I mean, were you like a funny kid? Were you cracking jokes?
Bai老师，他看到你的履历也非常好奇，就是您这么多才艺，曲艺表演，还有这个喜剧的表演，甚至是自己还会绘画，然后他想知道您是从小时候是从什么时候开始发现自己有喜剧方面的天赋？
我是八岁开始学习中国的戏曲，然后一直干到将近干了20多年吧，我开始从事曲艺。中国不是有传统的文化嘛，有戏曲，有曲艺，所以呢，我就特别喜欢文化这方面的。
So, Mr. Bai started out as an opera player at the 8 years old, and for 20 years he stayed in the profession, and then that's when he transitioned to the more comedian, comedic, happy, funny, 曲艺, the art of singing and speaking. It's very different from the traditional opera.
Yes, absolutely. Well, you know, I can relate a little bit because I was a performer for 25 years from when I was 10 till I was 35. But in addition to my singing that I did with my twin brother, I loved the most when in between the songs, I could speak with the audience, and I studied comedy, and I loved going out into the audience, sitting on people's laps, and to hear people laugh for me was much more invigorating and fulfilling than the clap of singing. So I can relate, and I love too that you've now traversed also into television and film. But anyway, I just wanted to share that with you and to see if you felt similarly in terms of the difference between hearing someone clap from when you sing versus hearing someone laugh when you're funny.
白老师，他对您刚才说的很有同感。他是从10岁到35岁这25年的时间里是做一个歌手，然后跟他的同胞兄弟孪生兄弟同台演出唱歌的中间，比如说两首歌的中间有一段时间呢，他们就会在台上讲一些笑话，然后把观众逗得哈哈大笑。 所以喜剧也是他着重的一个地方，然后呢，他很想知道您对于以戏曲的表演听到观众的掌声和以用喜剧的方式，然后听到观众的笑声，这两者有没有跟他有没有类似的想法？就是是否喜剧可能在您心中带来的影响力更大一点？我觉得他应该是这个意思。
对，我跟他有同感，因为我学习戏曲，我用我们戏曲的行话叫啥，三花脸儿、丑角儿，但是我也是在舞台上比较逗观众乐的那种戏剧小品呐，包括一些演出，我也喜欢在舞台上的那种感觉，掌声和鲜花，有人给我合照啊，拍给我合影啊、签名，我喜欢这种感觉。 说真的，干了这么多年呢，我一直没有后悔我从事艺术这个行当。不管挣钱多少无所谓，最重要是快乐，然后自己快乐，然后又把快乐分享给大家，这是我最大的愿望，也是我最喜欢的事儿。Well,
he felt you. So in his acting career, for many times he played clowns, and he enjoy people's laughs, their claps, and after the show, people come to the stage and asking to take a photo with him. And he felt like by spreading happiness, he bring himself the same amount of happiness.
I love that. And I can definitely, you know, relate. And what I love so much about your work is that whether you are singing or showcasing your comedic talent, music and comedy is transcendent of all language. And what I'm so excited about Phoenix is the fact that it's going to and has already connected artists from all over the world with one another, despite what language they speak. And I'm so excited about you coming on board and spreading your love and your gifts in music and comedy. And I'm wondering, you know, what it means to you to connect with other artists and fans around the world through your gifts of music and comedy.
白老师，他非常感谢你跟我们分享您的这些心路历程，他也是觉得这个菲尼这个平台能够帮助大家建立这样的一种联系，然后能够将曲艺，您能够将曲艺还有喜剧传播给更远的观众，而不是被语言，因为大家说不同的语言而阻挡了。
因为音乐是能够穿破语言的障碍的，就是对于菲尼音乐可以通过菲尼音乐将您的一些作品传达给更远的观众，有没有一些计划或者是想法？我这次呢非常开心呢，也非常高兴哈，能加入这个平台，我也希望我能把我的戏曲也好，歌曲也好，包括我的小品也好，分享给海内外的更多的朋友，让大家 在其中得到开心和快乐，这是我最大的希望。我也希望能通过这个平台吧，非常感谢大家对我的信任。So
Mr. Bai believes that Phoenix would be a great platform for people to spread happiness, and he would be among the first groups of them to do that. And he expresses gratitude to Phoenix. Thank you.
Well, I'm so grateful for his time today. And I'm so grateful that we are now connected through Phoenix. And I can't wait to continue to follow his career and also hopefully to one day collaborate.
非常感谢今天接受采访，希望以后能亲眼看到、亲身看到您的表演，还有您的一些曲艺的演出。
谢谢，我也希望成真的邀请你们到中国河南做客。河南就是少林寺功夫，哎，到少林寺，我们就在少林寺不远的地方住。哎，希望成真的邀请你们来做客。嗯，He
lives next to the Shaolin Temple, you know, the famous movie. So he invite you over there to learn some martial art
love to learn martial art.
他说他非常想学。Thank
you so much. Thank you.
In the digital age, artists and bands struggle to make a living. In fact, only a small number of artists can live off their craft. For the 98% of artists that don't have the luxury of being signed to a label, it's tough. But artists deserve to live off their art. Wherever you are around the world, appreciation of music does not change. Phoenix brings bands and their fans together, whilst allowing bands to properly monetize their passion. The Phoenix app will directly connect bands and fans with no need for middlemen. We're utilizing the blockchain to give the power back to the artists once and for all. Join Phoenix, join the change.